Hello guys, welcome to my channel after a long time. I promise to continue my vlogs in this year. So this is my first international travelogue of 2022. So now I will take you to the group of small islands named as Maldives. You can plan the whole trip by yourself without reaching out to any travel agency, but you should try one or two agency just to get a fair idea on the itinerary. So what we need for this trip? Flights, hotel bookings, activities, budget and safety. So let's discuss about the flight details first. You should require the mandatory RT-PCR test and you need to fill the health declaration in Maldives immigration site named as imogua.immigration.mb. You can also find the link below description. Once your flight reaching near Dumale, which is the main city of Maldives, you can see the breathtaking view of small group of islands over the Indian Ocean from your flight. Do not forget to take those clips because it's a lifetime experience. For me, it was 2 to 2.5 hour direct flight from Bangalore to Maldives. The flight will cost you around 17k INR to 22k INR max per passenger round trip. It's depend upon the season. You can consider November to March as peak season. After March, you can consider as wait season or off season. Since I wanted to celebrate the New Year on Maldives, that's why I planned my trip for 30th of December. For flight booking, you can reach out to different sites. You can compare the flight prices in vigo.com. And for booking, you can consider Guaibibo, Make My Trip, Yatra, Easy My Trip, etc. Once you arrive to Male Airport, you need to go to the booth of your reserved resort for speedboat transfer and health declaration for that private island or resort. Every private island and resort has their own booth in Male Airport. You can sit over the food court area and fill all the formalities there. After that, their agent will come to you and take you to the jetty area for speedboat transfer. For Maldives, basically there are two types of island. One is local or public island and another one is private island. So for local island, speedboat providers are already there, but for private island, once you reserved your bookings, you need to drop a mail to the main mail ID of that resort. They will send you the confirmation voucher along with the booth number in Male Airport. Also, they will mention the speedboat transfer fees and all the tax and charges over that mail chain. So once arrived in Male Airport, you need to go to that booth number as mentioned in the mail and they will instruct you for the next steps. From here itself in the jetty area, you can see the crystal clear water and you can enjoy the vibes. So their agent will take all your luggages to the speedboat and you can enjoy your ride safely and easily. For speedboat, it will cost you around $170 per passenger round trip for the private island. For local or public island, there are two options. One is either local ferry or the speedboat. For local ferry, it has particular timing. It will cost you less, but it will take more time to reach the island. The next important thing for booking of your resorts, either you can choose islands in North Male at all or South Male at all, because those islands are nearby to Male Airport and it will take maximum 45 minute speedboat transfer. But there are a couple of good resorts in South Ari Atoll, Ba Atoll or some other islands which are very far from the Male Airport. So again, you need to take the seaplane and you need to take the speedboat after that. Remember, every island is beautiful and unique on its own. We have chosen Meru Islands and Resort in North Male Atoll for our next few days. So here we arrived in our beautiful resort. They have welcomed us with their traditional dances as well as they have given us a nice chilled welcome drink to chill out.
After that, they have provided us the complimentary snacks in the nearby poolside restaurant because we just have missed our lunch due to late speedboat transfer. Remember, in the private island, there are a couple of restaurants and bar, and the receptionist will show you the complete map. Also, you can see available buggies for transferring from one place to another in any private island. You can always call to the main reception area from your room and they will send the buggy to your doorstep. So currently we are heading towards for our water villas. Private island has different categories of rooms, started from garden villa to beach villa to seafront and water villas. Water villas and seafront villas basically started from $600 to $800 per night. For beach villa or garden villa, you can find around 30,000 to 40,000 INR, that is approx $300 to $400 per night. Mostly there are 2 to 3 reception areas in front of different category villas, so you can always reach out to the reception area first. They will hand it over the keys to you along with the map, and after that you are good to go. The island also have couple of other sites to explore, like infinity pool, which is restricted to adults and ended towards the ocean. Also it has its own museum, which I will show you later in this video. During your reservation, you can always choose 3 services like half boat, full boat or all inclusive plan. In full boat, 3 times meals are included, in half boat only 1 time, and for all inclusive, you can also avail unlimited drinks in your villa. Apart from that, spa and some activities also included over there. You can also spot baby sharks or lots of fishes due to crystal clear water over there. Let me take you to our room tour then. At first, you can see the mini bar over there. So you can take any of the drinks from there free of cost if you opted in for the all-inclusive plan. Apart from that, you can see life jacket, bathrobes, locker, fridge, umbrellas, etc. in the cupboard area. This is the spacious bathroom. Also, there is jacuzzi area. From the jacuzzi, you can directly go to the sea via staircase. Remember, for children, it's strictly prohibited. You can observe how beautifully they have decorated our bedroom. Also, they have provided sparkling wine as a welcome drink and couple of fruits along with that. So this is the main attraction of any water villa in any private island. From the balcony area, you can see the breathtaking and mesmerizing view of Indian Ocean. And you can chill out here with a glass of wine. However, in the night time, you can spot plenty of sharks from your water villa in the sea. Let's get ready for the dinner. I will show you how the island is lightened up for the festive season. You can hear the noise of the waves and also the cool breeze. You can see the water villas, how it looks like in the night time. I think I need a better camera to capture all those views. So regarding the food, you can always get plenty of varieties of food in breakfast, lunch and dinner. Water is always free. For drinks, you need to pay extra. However, in Sunday morning, you can get unlimited champagne free. For non-vegetarians, I can say there are lots of options in seafood and live counter food. But for vegetarians, only few options are there in main course. But you can always enjoy the dessert section over there. Every morning, I can witness this beautiful sunrise from my water villa. You need to come to the nearby restaurant for your breakfast, lunch and dinner, and a host assigned to you for the next few days you are staying over there. Do not worry about the safety and precautions over there because they are basically taking care of everything. Whenever you need to visit any nearby restaurant, you should wear your mask. Do not forget to put sunscreen over your skin because at the end of the day you will get tanned badly due to beach area. But I totally loved the windy weather over there. time for a nice sea bath and the snorkeling. I always recommend you to buying your own snorkeling kit whenever you plan for Maldives, because renting kit is always costlier than buying your own kit, and you can easily find the snorkeling kit in Decathlon in India. However, you can always opt for the water sports or water activities in your private or local island, like surfing, kayaking, deep sea scuba diving or deep sea snorkeling. But for every other activities, you need to pay extra. However, your private island always provide you the free snorkeling session. Do not forget to take your waterproof zipper pouch or the GoPro with you to take the shots underwater. Non-swimmers also can do the snorkeling under the seashore till the depth you are comfortable in. You can easily spot lots of fishes, corals, shells, etc. under the seashore. So, this is the main reception area where you can ask all of your queries at any time, at any day. Also, you can opt in for any kind of activities from here. Remember, for booking of any resorts or hotels, you can reach out to different sites like booking.com or agoda.com, etc. From there, you can find plenty of options. You can reserve first, but automatically before 2 days of your arrival, the pay will be deducted from your card. Also, there are a couple of gift shops like this in any private island. Remember, in Maldives, only dollar or Maldivian rupiah is accepted. There are plenty of gaming areas in private islands like golf course, chess area or other gaming rooms you can also find there. The complete island is just like a beautiful wallpaper. The more you explore the island, you will find more interesting places. So this is the whale skeleton section where they have preserved a huge skeleton over there. Did you ever see this much huge skeleton? We also went to the garden villas just to show you how it looks like from inside. Every room is huge and spacious on its own in any private island. We have booked water villa for 3 nights and seafront villa for 2 nights. The highest category rooms are water villa and seafront villa, and after that you can opt for garden villa or beach villa. The next eternity we have booked is the yacht ride. From the yacht, they will show you the beautiful sunset over the Indian Ocean. Along with that, if you are lucky enough, you can easily spot dolphin over the sea. I can say it was quite a bumpy ride. For per passenger, the yacht ride will cost approximately $34 to $50, depend upon the private island. We have spotted the last sunset of 2021 from the yacht over the sea, and it was breathtaking. Once our yacht ride has been completed and we return back to our private island, we just saw our island is beautifully decked up and lightened up for the 31st night. Also, we have observed they have decorated the islands with some beautiful standards. Remember, for the 31st night, there was mandatory gala night charges for any resorts or any hotels in Maldives. So we have paid almost $250 for the gala night. But I can say for the one time, it worth the money. For other time or other season in the year, you don't need to pay the gala night. You need to pay these charges only for Christmas or New Year. Also, we have explored the museum over there. As I already told, there are lots of places in any private island to explore.
They have organized a beautiful gala dinner and we have dressed up according to the theme.
You can see the beautiful decoration all over the restaurant. They have decorated the restaurant with lots of balloons, lights, and they also provided some props to enjoy. Next, I will show you how we have celebrated the 31st night.
Don't you know? Them girls, they love the coco. Don't need to.
Good morning. So this is the first day of 2022 and we are still dealing with the last night hangover. We are not getting bored at Maldives at all. Every day is a new day. And we are happy to explore new places over the island every day. This is the Meru Clinic where you need to do the RT-PCR test again before your departure. Also, in any private island or local island, RT-PCR test is mandatory during your exit. So it will cost $50 per passenger.
This morning, we have shifted to our next category room, that is Seafront Villa. I must say this is one of the best luxurious villa over the island. You can see how spacious the room is. Even from here, you can enjoy the breathtaking view of the sea.
I personally like this villa more than the water villa. The villa has a spacious washroom along with jacuzzi and the seating area. Every day we have spotted different kinds of creature under the seashore. We love to do snorkeling every day. During our snorkeling that day, we have spotted lots of seaweeds along with some yellow fishes. Also, we have spotted shells under the seashore. You can see how people are enjoying the snorkeling activity there. Again, on the next day, we have spotted this cute little fish. If you are lucky enough, you can also spot beautiful seabirds over the island. We are lucky enough that we have also spotted a baby shark during our snorkeling under the seashore. So you should always take precautions over there because in Maldives, sharks are very common. The next place I will take you to the infinity pool. This place is restricted to only adults due to its depth. If you see the pool, it will always sink with the ocean. That's how it's named as infinity pool. Very sad to say this is the last night for us over this island. We have enjoyed every bit of this journey. During our dinner, we also observed the island is still lightened up so beautifully that we can't take off our eyes. They also organized a movie night under the stars. Last but not the least, do not forget to take travel insurance online for any international travel journey due to the COVID situation. Thank you. I hope you have enjoyed my video. Stay tuned for the next episode where I will take you to the Male City tour, as well as I will show you the most awaiting submarine ride there. In my next video, I also discuss about the budget, how can you plan for Maldives. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Please do feedback in the comment box. Also press the bell icon for upcoming notification. Till then, tata, bye bye.